So far, we've reviewed how to develop your story, how to create slides that support your storytelling, and now we're going to turn to some ideas for actually giving your presentation in an effective way. We're going to look at three different things. First of all, we're going to review ways to prepare to give your presentation. Then we're going to talk about a few different speaking tips. And finally, we'll talk about ways of handling questions after you're done giving your presentation. Let's start out with some ideas for preparing.
One important part of preparation is to plan realistically for time. Communicate with the chairperson or host of your event to confirm the amount of time you have to speak. Make sure to plan time for questions, whether they be during the talk or during a question and answer period after the talk. And finally, if you're one of the later speakers in a series of presentations, be prepared to condense your talk in case the meeting gets behind schedule. The next part of preparation is knowing what you're going to say. Now, many people put lots of text on their slides so that the script for their talk is essentially displayed on the slides themselves. But if you follow our guidelines for minimalist slide creation, your slides will not have much text on them. Instead of creating slides that have to serve as cue cards, you can do one of three things to deliver your talk. The first option is to write your talk and then memorize it. This is realistic for a 10 to 15 minute conference presentation, but may be more challenging for longer presentations. The second option is to print out your presenter notes ahead of time and refer to them while you're advancing your slides. The third option is to use the on-screen presenter display within your presentation software. This can be the best option when you're able to use your own computer for your presentation. If you have to present your talk using a different computer, don't assume that the presenter display will work properly without testing it first. The final and most important step in preparing your talk is to practice. Do your talk over and over again until you're confident that it can be done within the allotted time and you're comfortable matching the story you're telling with the slides you've created to support that story.
We've reviewed some important things to consider when preparing for your talk. Now let's discuss some strategies for giving your talk. And we could spend all day on this, but we've picked out just a few highlights that we find to be very useful for most scientific presenters. So even if you've practiced your talk and feel really prepared, you can still have some pre-talk jitters. Your stomach might feel a little bit weird or your heart is beating really quickly. This is perfectly normal. A lot of us have been giving talks for 20 years and every now and then we still have that right before. It just means that your body is energized and ready to do this, which is a good thing. So when you feel that, don't get freaked out. Just harness that energy and go give a great talk.
When people get nervous, they tend to talk quickly. Be sure to breathe and slow down. Every now and then, pause to take a full inhale and exhale. It might seem like you're pausing for a long time, but you're actually not. And if you have been talking very quickly, this will give your audience a moment to catch up with you.
Use a sincere and engaging tone. You should be excited about the ideas you're presenting, and you want to express that excitement as clearly and sincerely as possible.
When you give a talk, you are really teaching your talk to the audience, and good teachers know to repeat key messages in different ways to make sure the audience understands. Scientific presentations can sometimes include very dense and complex ideas, and it can be very helpful to the audience for you to repeat key ideas at a more abstract level.
With enough practice, you should be able to give your talk within a set amount of time. But while you're up there, you still want to keep track of time. So before you begin your talk, make sure that you can easily see a clock.
Quickly recapping our speaking tips, pre-talk bodily sensations are normal. Breathe and slow down. Use a sincere and engaging tone. Repeat key ideas. Keep track of time.
Finally, let's discuss some strategies for handling questions after your talk.
Some people get nervous about the question and answer period after a talk, but if you're prepared, it's really a great opportunity to maintain or increase excitement about the topic and to show that you're in command of your material. We're going to review 4 tips for handling questions. First, repeat the question for the rest of the audience. This ensures that the audience hears the question. It's also a check to make sure that you've understood the question correctly and can buy you a little time while you formulate your answer.
So the question is, how do these results vary by type of insurance?
Sometimes a question might not be very clear to you. If that happens, it's okay to ask the questioner to rephrase the question.
Thanks so much for your question. I want to be sure that I understand appropriately so that I can answer it fully. Could you ask me again?
Sometimes a question is beyond the scope of your presentation. In that case, offer to discuss the issue with the person after your talk.
That's a really important issue. It wasn't actually within the scope of the current project, but I do think it does bear some exploration, and I'd love to talk to you afterwards if you'd like a little bit more about that.
Oftentimes, you might not know the answer to a question. It's okay to say that you don't know and to acknowledge that it's a good question.
That's a really good question. I actually don't know the answer, but you've definitely triggered my next research topic.
Let's quickly recap our tips for handling questions. Repeat the question for the audience. It's okay to ask the questioner to rephrase their question. If the question is beyond the scope of your presentation, offer to discuss it after the talk. Lastly, it's okay to say you don't know, but acknowledge that it's a good question. We've covered a lot of material in this series of videos, but most of it can be boiled down to a few simple tips. Tell a good story. Don't make heavy demands on people's eyes, ears, or brains. Use slides with high contrast and large font size.
You know, effectively presenting your ideas and findings is really challenging, but it can also be one of the most satisfying things that you do as a scientist. It can also have an impact that might be far greater than you had anticipated.
Thanks for watching this series of videos, and good luck with your presentations. This educational program is supported by a grant from the National Center for Advancing Translational Sciences.
Scientific presentations tend to convey, I have no idea what I'm supposed to be saying.
Now let's discuss things that you can do to help deliver.
So, wait, that was a rambling question? You guys need a producer or anything? I'm happy to jump in that role if needed.
I don't like that one either.